You know how fast you're going?
What? How fast you're going?
I don't know. 10?
8.
Be advised, this is an explicit podcast. If you're easily offended, get your panties twisted into a knot. Leave now. Run in your safe space. Get you a little cloth for your tears. All the opinions expressed on this podcast are those of the host and his guest and do not reflect the opinions of any local or government agency. Welcome. Motor Cop Chronicles podcast. Your host, Iceman. It's going to be the end of watch episode. I apologize. I understand I'm late with it. I didn't forget. Like I said, everybody knows this is not the episodes that I like to do anyway, but I didn't forget. It's late. Unfortunately, there was 8 in line of duty deaths for the month of June. Quite a few canines also. So let's go ahead and get it started. Pay our respect for the men and women that gave their life in the line of duty. June the 1st, police officer Horan Randy Taylor from the Madison Police Department, Mississippi, end of watch Thursday, June the 1st, cause of death was gunfire. His age is not available, 34 years on the job. Officer Tyler was shot and killed during a tactical operation at a home on Terrapin Hill Road in North Brandon, Mississippi. A subject armed with a rifle and handgun and also wearing a bulletproof vest had broken into a home at about 1:20 a.m. and took two women hostage. As Brandon Police Department officers arrived at the scene, one of the women was able to escape, but the second remained a hostage. Negotiators were able to arrange for the release of the hostage, but the man remained in the home. At approximately 0600 hours, he opened fire on officers, critically wounding an officer with the Brandon Police Department. The Madison Police Department's special response team responded to the scene as part of a mutual aid request as negotiators continued to have the man surrender. The man opened fire on officers a second time at about 9:30 a.m., and Officer Tyler was mortally wounded. The subject was also killed in the exchange. Officer Tyler had served with the Madison Police Department for 7 years and was supervisor of the Narcotics Division. He had previously retired as a police chief of Ridgeland Police Department after serving 27 years. He was a graduate of the 228th session of the FBI National Academy. An entire life of service there. Corporal Sean Kevin Kelly from the Denham Springs Police Department in Louisiana. End of watch was Friday, June the 2nd, 2023. Cause of death was gunfire. Now, I had an episode on him. He was 53 years old, 29 years of service. Corporal Sean Kelly succumbed to a gunshot wound sustained on May the 11th, 2023, after responding to a disorderly subject call in Spring Park Plaza at around 4:30 p.m. A man had been involved in several road rage incidents in the area and was arguing with a woman he did not know in the parking lot of a shopping center. Corporal Kelly was working a traffic assignment but responded to the scene because patrol officers were on other calls. He and another officer arrived at the scene The man opened fire from his car, striking Corporal Kelly multiple times. The man fled but was shot and killed by a Lewis Parish Sheriff's deputy after he approached the deputy while holding a gun. Corporal Kelly was transported to a local hospital where he remained in critical condition until succumbing to his wounds 22 days later on June the 2nd. Corporal Kelly had served with the Denham Springs Police Department for 4 years. He had previously served with the Louisiana Department of Corrections and had a total of 29 years of law enforcement service. He is survived by his wife, children, and grandchildren. Next is Sergeant Corey Maynard of West Virginia State Police, West Virginia. End of watch was Friday, June the 2nd, 2023. Cause of death was gunfire. He was 37 years of age. He had 15 years on the job. Sergeant Maynard was shot and killed while responding to a shooting call in the Beach Creek area of Mingo County at about 3:30 p.m. The subject opened fire on responding officers, fatally wounding Sergeant Maynard. The man fled the scene but was captured approximately 6 hours later. Sergeant Maynard had served with the West Virginia Police for over 15 years. He is survived by his wife and his two children. Bad guy was arrested, says Next, we have Chief of Police Anthony Rickerson from the Jasper Police Department, Florida. End of watch was June the 11th, 2023. Cause of death was an automobile crash. He was 43 years of age, 13 years on a job. The chief was killed in a vehicle crash at about 10:25 p.m. He was en route to backup officers who were responding to an unauthorized block party in Jasper when his vehicle struck a deer in the road. His patrol truck careened off the roadway, struck a large tree, and became engulfed in flames. He had served with the Jasper Police Department for 13 years and was appointed as chief in September of 2022. He had previously served with the Jennings Police Department and the Florida Department of Corrections. He is survived by his wife and his three children. We have Police Officer Mark Christopher Wagner II of Wintergreen Police Department, Virginia. End of watch was Friday, June the 16th, 2023. Cause of death was gunfire. He was 31 years of age, 4 years on the job. Officer Wagner was shot and killed after responding to a domestic disturbance call at a home on Arrowwood Lane at about 10 p.m. A man had assaulted two other men in the home and then left the residence. Officer Wagner located the subject in the wood line near the house after arriving on the scene. A struggle ensued, and during which Officer Wagner was shot and killed with his own duty weapon. The subject was also shot during the struggle. The subject was arrested by Wintergreen police officers and deputies from the Nelson County Sheriff's Office. He was charged with capital murder, use of a firearm in the commission of felony, and two counts of malicious wounding. Officer Wagner had served with the Wintergreen Police Department for 3 years. He had previously served as a police officer with the Massanutten Police Department for 1 year. He is survived by his mother, father, stepmother, three brothers, and a sister. Bad guy was charged with capital murder. Next, we have Trooper Jaquez F. Rogo Jr. from Pennsylvania State Police in Pennsylvania. End of watch was June 17, 2023. He was 29 years old. He had 2 years and 11 months on the job. Cause of death was gunfire. Trooper was shot and killed by a wanted man near the intersection of Swamp Road and Baumgartner Drive in Walker Township shortly after 3 p.m. At about 11 a.m., the subject had entered the parking lot of the Pennsylvania State Police Troop G and shot several patrol cars using a large caliber hunting rifle. The man fled the scene and called 911 several times as they searched for him. The man then shot and critically wounded a Pennsylvania State Police lieutenant at about 12:45 before fleeing again. Shortly before 3 p.m., the man was located in the shopping center of the Walker Township and then fled to a nearby wooded area where he and the trooper were both killed during a shootout. Trooper had served with the Pennsylvania State Police for almost 3 years. He is survived by his wife. The trooper Aaron Smith from the Indiana State Police in Indiana. End of watch was Wednesday, June 28th, 2023. His age is not available. He was 5 years on the job, also a military veteran. Cause of death was vehicular assault. Trooper Smith was struck and killed by a stolen vehicle at about 8:30 p.m. while deploying stop strips to terminate a vehicle pursuit on Ronald Reagan Parkway north of I-70. Other troopers initiated a pursuit when the vehicle fled as they attempted to stop it at about 8:40 p.m. Trooper Smith was deploying spike strips when he was hit by the fleeing vehicle. The car crashed after hitting the trooper. The driver and a vehicle passengers, including a juvenile, were taken to a local hospital. The driver was charged with murder, and one of the passengers was charged with auto theft. Another passenger was reported as a missing juvenile from Missouri and will not be charged. Trooper Smith was a United States Army National Guard veteran and served with the Indiana State Police for 5 years. He is survived by his wife. Next, we have Police Officer Carlos Taylor from the Montgomery Police Department in Alabama. End of watch was Friday, March the 30th, 2023. He was 29 years of age. He had 2 years on the job. The cause of death was an automobile crash. Officer Taylor succumbed to complications of injury sustained in a vehicle crash that happened on February 17th of 2017 at the intersection of Spring Valley Road and Woodley Road. He was responding to a needs assistance call of the officers pursuing two men with a gun. He was traveling south on the road in an unmarked patrol car when he attempted to avoid hitting another vehicle. His patrol car crossed into another lane and collided with another vehicle. He suffered a traumatic injury to his brain stem that resulted in him being a quadriplegic and unable to verbally communicate. He remained under constant care until he succumbed to his injuries June 30, 2023. He had served with the Montgomery Police Department for 2 years. And that was all, thank goodness, for that month. Still too many. Next, we'll move on to the canines. We have Canine Chase. Cobb County Police Department, Georgia. End of watch was Tuesday, June the 6th. It's a Belgian Malinois male, 4 years old. He'd been on job for 3 years, 2 months. Cause of death was heat stroke. He succumbed to heat-related injuries when the air conditioning malfunctioned in his Angeles patrol vehicle around 2 p.m. They had participated in a scheduled active shooter drills at a high school. Officer checked on their canines every 45 minutes. Canine Chase's handler noticed that the air conditioner was not running during one of the breaks. Despite life-saving efforts, Canine just died at a local veterinary clinic. This canine had been named after Patrolman Chase Maddox of the Locust Grove Police Department in Georgia. With K-9 Aaron from the Houston Police Department. End of watch was June the 12th. He was a Belgian Malinois male, 4 years old. He'd been on job 1 year, 6 months. Cause of death was heat stroke. He also died in the patrol vehicle after the temperature alarm system failed while the patrol unit was idling. Air conditioner went out. System malfunction when air conditioning failed. The handler returned to his vehicle and noticed that the dog was in distress. He transported him to a veterinary clinic where he succumbed to his injuries. And we have K-9 Harry from the Shreveport Police Department, Louisiana. End of watch was Saturday, June 24th, 2023. Breed Belgian Malinois, male, 7 years old. He'd been on the job for 6 years. He died when he suffered a heat stroke while tracking subjects who fled on foot earlier after crashing a stolen vehicle. At 4:45 p.m., K-9 Harry and his handler were assisting officers in locating the subjects who abandoned the stolen vehicle in a vehicle pursuit. K-9 Harry began exhibiting signs of heat-related injury, and he was taken to the animal emergency intensive care unit where efforts to save him were unsuccessful. Shreveport's temperature was in the 90s, heat index well above 100. He served the police department for 6 years. And it's going to be it for this month. Make sure to check on their dogs and don't overwork them canine dogs. It's way too hot out there. So far for the year, we've had a total of 57 in the line of duty deaths. Of course, the majority of gunshots, 28. Come in second, automobile crashes. And the highest state it's looking like is, Louisiana. Okay. Let's hope next month is less numbers. I know it won't be zero because I already have some, but let's hope it don't go up any higher. So everybody needs to, if you're praying people, keep these men and women in your thoughts and prayers, and especially their families that are still here, that they paid off and sacrificed. And everybody be safe out there.
Some have said that time heals, but gathered together here today, we know that's not true. The facts still remain. The empty chair, the unfulfilled dreams, the pain, the hurt, the loneliness. We ask your blessing upon the families who have been impacted by the loss of a loved one in the line of duty.
Took it on to pleasure life in the words you spoke for people that don't care or even know you. You trained for months, now it's time to go out on the streets where we all know the danger and the hatred makes it to you. Safety fools you. You pulled a man from his burning car, but his child who died has left a scar. You live with death for life, but no one helps you.
Given to honor her this morning. Her body was taken from the medical examiner's office in Norfolk, Newport News.
She screams at
so
you
many people
you find
gathered to show
night.
Their respect.
She
just look
calls
at how
you
they lined the streets of downtown Norfolk. And at just 24 years old, Officer Tyne died in the line of duty on Thursday evening. It happened during a traffic stop on 16th Street in Newport News. She began talking to the driver of a car. She and one other officer had pulled over. The driver, burning green, had his car door open while they were talking. He suddenly took off, and Tyne was not able to step out of the way in time, so the car dragged her. It crashed, and Tyne was pinned between the door and the tree.
Just 6 months ago, Newport News Chief Steve Drew congratulated new officer E.O.W.
Communications to all units. Please be advised that a position for Officer Tyne has arrived in our city.
But Saturday, he joined his city, thanking her for his selfless
watch. Your friends been shot. I am in on a traffic stop. You spend the whole night searching for a killer.
Holding back tears, people on as every law enforcement agency in Hampton Roads is stopped by Officer Tyne's assigned South
Precinct.
Now here's that confrontation again. This is from the other officer's body camera. Police returned fire, and the suspect, who we now know as Bruce Lua, was hit in the leg but survived. Both of the injured officers are also okay, and in fact, they were saluted as they left the hospital later that day. Now, Lua is now charged with attempted murder and aggravated battery. COPA's investigation still